Hey, Crypto Bros, hope you guys are having a great day wherever you are and you're enjoying the current state of the market. We're going to be discussing about regulation because it is coming full force. We've been discussing it for the past few months. We're going to discuss crypto assets that's going to do very well, that's innovating the space, and why I believe also Zen is ready for regulation. Let's go ahead and get into this, guys. We're seeing Texas could be the first U.S. state to regulate cryptocurrency. Now, we've seen with Florida and Texas being the innovation hub for crypto, we're seeing that even Texas at this point is ready to regulate the crypto space, guys. And regulation can be good at times. Don't get me wrong. It can be good because it's protecting the average investors. There is these regulatory bodies in the government, and they, believe it or not, they are looking for the average investor's best interest. Now, what we've seen in regards to XRP, that hasn't been the case because we've seen XRP take a hit overall and not do so well in the previous bull market due to the fact that the SEC went after XRP and other crypto assets. Now, look, sometimes things don't go as planned when it comes to regulation. I do believe, like, as long as the government can keep themselves out of a certain sector and just let the free market overall do its thing, it will overall be more successful. Okay, it will prosper a lot more. However, due to the fact that there is no regulation in the space, there's a lot of rug pulls, there's a lot of things failing in the space, and a lot of scams and things like that. So that's why we have a regulatory body to go after these particular things. Now, I'm all for good innovation. I'm all good for good regulation, guys. Because if you regulate the space in the proper way, where you have an actual framework, where you don't allow these innovation to go overseas, right? Then that's good. That's good overall for the country because you're continuing to innovate. You're providing your investors and your consumers with products and services that are basically expanding and continuing to grow overall. So what we're seeing is that Texas is implementing the on exchanges, the maintaining of reserve significance to fulfill their obligations to customer. Now, this is very good overall because you should, if you are interacting with an exchange, we should be able to trust that exchange to know that they do have their proper reserves, that if 200, 300, 500, or thousands of people go out and try to withdraw their money, that the funds are actually available to them. On top of this, storing the reserves in the Ambience account where customers' digital assets are not strictly segregated from each other. So meaning what happened with FTX, guys. We saw that FTX had different types of accounts. They're playing with customer funds overall and indulging in those actual money. So this is something that's actually good. It protects the consumer knowing that your funds are actually there for you, even though, you know, exchanges is the whole problem overall in the cryptocurrency space. You should be, again, taking your funds off of the exchange. You should be self-custodying. That was the whole point, is to take out the middleman overall, and we're continuing to create these middlemen. However, why not create some regulation that if people wanted to keep their funds on exchange, which you shouldn't, at any point you shouldn't, that you're actually still safe in some form or some manner. So again, we even seen sometimes exchanges come out and show specific digits on your account, right? You log into your exchange account, you see $100 there, but we know that the $100 is not actually in the reserve, okay? It's somewhere, somebody's enjoying it, a cocktail or a margarita somewhere in the Bahamas. You know, we don't want to see those type of things, guys. So we want to see innovation continue to happen in the space. And the only way it can continue is that we don't have these rug pulls, especially happening with exchanges and knowing that they can maintain their reserves, guys. And one project is poised to do very well, and that's the BAX token, guys. Okay, and BAX. We've seen BAX. We've been talking about this overall for the past few months on our channel. Look, BAX is running toward regulation. They're not fearing and they're not shying away. And that's why I say, look, you got to create a portfolio that basically is regulated friendly. It's ready, even if regulation comes in, that it's not going to be hit so hard. yes, even if regulation comes into the space, and we're seeing some of that come in already, we've seen a lot of these crypto assets essentially not come into par with regulation. And that's why I say, look, Zen, perfect, because there is no pre-allocation of a founder. He's just part of the community. You just basically go in and mint your coins. You're minting your own coins, essentially. And there is no front end where somebody could basically shut it down, right? So you're basically having this this ability to not be under scrutiny when it comes to regulation. So this is good. Zen, that's why I recommend it. Overall friendly for regulation. And is will continue to do well because they're continuing to innovate in the space, guys. Same thing with BAB, guys. They're running toward regulation. They're creating their own mainnet that allows you to basically do DeFi in the regulated space. Now, again, we're talking about the whole purpose of DeFi, decentralized finance, is that you're decentralized, right? There's no central entity. But again, you can still interact with, again, this protocol, this network, in a user-friendly, regulated manner, which is not too bad, okay? Which is can bring medium exchange for developing countries, knowing that they're safe. Because when you're trying to offer crypto, right, to people in the third world countries, guys, and when these exchanges left and right are scamming people out of, they're scamming people out of their funds, right? And when they don't have too much funds to actually invest, how bad does that look for the cryptocurrency market, guys? How bad does that look for the overall space? It doesn't look too good when you have bad actors like this stealing the average person in a third world country, guys. It looks very, very bad overall. So that's why BAB is offering these features, so that it protects the normal person who doesn't have $50 or $20. They have maybe $5 or $10 overall, United States dollar I'm talking about, where they can actually get in, you know, get exposure to some of these particular assets in a cheap manner, okay? Now, if you can say to yourself, okay, is Ethereum cheap overall in terms of for the third world countries? It's not cheap overall. When you're talking about fees that are exceeding $30, $40, $50, it's not so cheap for that. How do you bring in mass adoption when fees are so expensive? You really can't. And how can you bring in mass adoption when you're getting rug pulled left and right? You can't. So this mainnet, overall, you're going to be interacting with the BAX token, the utility token here. And you're going to be able to do DeFi on there in a safe, efficient manner where you're not going to be actually rug pulled. So this is amazing to see how this is actually going to play out. What type of yields are going to be generated from this? Are they going to be liquidity pools, farming? So in a safe, regulated DeFi space. So I'm astonished to see what's going to be happening here. Very cool things to see as they're continuing to develop, guys. And that's why we talk about a portfolio where, look, you have big macro coins like Bitcoin, Ethereum on there to protect your overall portfolio, right? So you have the big macro cap coins. And then you also have things like you have the high risk, right? You have like Zen, you have BAB. As much as we like to say that they're not high risk, they are high risk, but they are going to bring you high reward at the end of the day, guys. So that's the cool thing, right? Same thing that's happening with BAB. Look, innovating, they are a small market cap coin. However, they can bring you a great amount of gains overall. And that's why we talk about risk management, guys. So have 20 to 30% into good altcoins that are ready for regulation no matter what happens. So that's good. And also, you have the big macro cap coins, so 30 to 40% in Ethereum and Bitcoin, or you can basically take some of that profits, put it into Bitcoin. And then you also have dry powder ready to go, whether it's in stable coins. We think that stable coins are going to, you know, be here overall for regulation. So that's also going to be, you can base it off of your judgment, whether you want to have it in United States dollar and deploy it there, but you always want to have some side cash ready to take on the opportunity when it presents itself, guys. So we talk about this on our channel, right? You take profits because you know that the market is always going to present you with opportunities no matter what, guys. You know, people that come into the space, they say, oh, I miss this meme coin, I miss that meme coin. But they don't understand is that, look, there's an abundance of opportunity in the crypto space. There's always abundance when it comes to investing. And that's why you always have to take profits and, you know, buy back in when there's opportunities in the market, guys. So I highly, highly recommend that. Let me know in the comment section, you think Zen will do good when it comes to regulation? Do you think BAB is ready head on? Let me know, guys, if these are good picks overall, because I want to hear your thoughts. I want to hear what you guys are actually thinking when it comes to investing. And maybe I should be changing my thesis overall. But we continue to see that Zen overall do very well, because once DB's NFTs actually come out, guys, we do know that it's going to take a lot of the future supply off, and it's going to continue make Zen more deflationary overall. We already see that there's 12.4 total in supply, trillion in supply, with a liquid of 10.37, which is a huge amount. Now, if we go to the actual section where we see total mined, right, we go to total mined section, or this one will be actually better. So we see that there's 107, okay, being in the process of being mined, okay? And some of that is already going to be taken off of the future supply once DB's NFTs come out, guys. What do you think is going to happen there? The shock that's going to be happening to the actual supply of Zen. There's just not going to be enough Zen, guys. And if more projects actually continue to come out on Zen and drives more demand where people want to invest in this ecosystem because there's good quality projects they want to get into, then it's just going to basically spell very well overall for price. So what Jack Levin is actually doing here is pretty amazing, guys, okay? And this is the sentiment that I want to see, right? In the comment section of my previous videos, I see people already giving hope on Zen, right? They've already lost hope in Zen because, look, we had that big nice run-up in Zen, and then we completely just crashed, guys. Okay, but as long as the innovation and development continues to happen and projects continue to come out on Zen and continue to make Zen more deflationary, it spells very well overall in the next year or two. It just boggles my mind, and it shows me that a lot of people don't actually understand the Zen ecosystem. Now, also the bad thing is that, look, when something is so complicated, people don't actually understand it. They tend to like leave it off and not reinterest themselves in learning about the actual ecosystem or project, even though it's innovative, guys. Sometimes complicated things don't do actually too well in the crypto space, because if it's too complicated, people are not interested in it. But I do believe that Zen can actually, you know, drive that factor where it's easy. You can actually go and mint, right? You can go and buy, market buy. There's sometimes there are opportunities where you can actually market buy Zen. We've seen that in the past, right? We know that, look, maybe market buying at certain times is better because you have liquid Zen available to you where you can actually invest into these projects that are going to be coming out, because in order for you to invest in them, you have to burn Zen. So you have to have liquid Zen, right? Minting takes a little bit of time to, you know, make those Zen available to you. So by burning and participating, so you can go market buy, right? That's why I say if newer projects come out that are very good and innovative, and they provide good, you know, incentive to participate in them, that's why people are going to go buy, which drives the price up overall, and then they participate in that project, right? Same thing we saw in Phoenix. We saw people come out, they bought Zen if they don't have liquid Zen available to them, right? They went and bought Zen to participate in Phoenix, which can drive the price up overall. So there has to be buyers at the end of the day, at the other side of this, for that particular asset to go up in value, guys. So again, a lot of people losing hope, which is nice to see, because innovation continues to happen in this ecosystem. And that I know, look, supply and demand, guys. Let's see how this plays out. It's in my portfolio. Is it in your portfolio? Let me know in the comment section below. I'll leave you off with that. I hope you enjoyed this video, guys. Give it a thumbs up. Until next time, as always, stay profitable.